Praise the Lord, beautiful people of God. Hear the word of the Lord this morning. From Paul, a slave of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for God's good news. God promised this good news about his son ahead of time through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures. His son was descended from David. He was publicly identified as God's son with power through his resurrection from the dead, which was based on the spirit of holiness. This son is Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, we have received God's grace and our appointment to be apostles. This was to bring all Gentiles to faithful obedience for his name's sake. You who are called by Jesus Christ are also included among these Gentiles. To those in Rome who are dearly loved by God and called to be God's people, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 1, verses 1 through 7. Salutations or greetings, said the voice. When I say salutations, it's just my fancy way of saying hello or good morning. Charlotte's Web's E.B. White. I have read Charlotte's Web more times than I can remember. My mother was an elementary school teacher, and this was a perennial favorite in our family. I remember relating to the confusion of Wilbur the pig when I first heard the word salutations. Now, 3 decades after my first reading of the book, salutations may be going by the wayside. When we wrote pen and paper to each other, we would address each other with a dear Mrs. Smith, or at least a sterile yet respectful to whom it may concern. Now, in the era of digital communications, we are moving away from salutations at all. How strange it seems to us then to read this salutation from Paul to people in a city which he had never visited. This is precisely why this greeting is longer and more robust than any others we see in Paul's writing. He is trying to share his identity and his purpose. He is sharing his devotion to Jesus Christ. Of all the ways that Paul could identify himself, geographical location, social status, family configuration, he is identifying first and foremost with the person of Jesus Christ. Why does Paul take such a length to identify himself this way? It is to be a relationship. Paul is committed by virtue of his devotion to Jesus, to other individuals and communities who share that relationship. No matter what things are counted as diverse or different among them, their bond in Jesus Christ keeps them together. Do we feel a similar bond to people we have never met? Could we? Let us pray. God of relationship, help us to identify with your child Jesus so that we may share in the bonds of grace and peace. Amen. Once again, I'm going to encourage you to subscribe to this channel, and please pass this devotion to 5 new people and encourage them to subscribe as well. God bless you, and you have a great day.